I want to do an overview of how our system actually performs on a bad day, or a couple of bad days actually in here. This one is from Quartzsite, and normally the days are pretty nice and sunny here in the winter time, but we had a few bad days for sure. This one is a weekly overview. It's starting out here with Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and so on. And as we approach Wednesday, this one is the voltage on the Tesla batteries. We actually didn't reach full charge, so we barely reached the top up here. Wednesday it rained all day, or Thursday it rained all day long. Thursday or Friday it wasn't such a great weather, and then Saturday it finally came up to a full charge again. But the voltage on a Tesla battery is actually very similar to the state of charge in here. So if we go look at a single day, this one by the way here is the input from the sun. As you can see, there was almost no input on Thursday down here. As we go look on Thursday, this one is now the data just for a single day in here. And as you can see, the state of charge up here, 100 is at the top, down here is zero. There's a lot of data on this graph, but it's kind of combined in here. But the yellow one is the state of charge. The blue is actually the voltage of the Tesla battery. So as I mentioned, these ones are tightly related, where the voltage on the battery follows the state of charge very closely actually. The other parts of this graph is the gray is what we consume in the RV. So you can see overnight you've been running the furnace once in a while, but we have a pretty high base load at around 250 watt in here. Then we have an electric water kettle. We use it for coffee and tea. The electric water heater kicks in at a reduced rate in here. We use the other things, and you will see several times during the day the electric water heater kick in. The orange is the input of the sun, so this one is a pretty low day. But if we actually go to Saturday in here, the day where it actually ends up being fully charged in here, we can see the voltage grows, then it flatlines at the top where we can't really output much more or accumulate more. And here we would have had more energy out here, but the batteries end up being 100% charged and basically it's tapering off because we can't use it in here. Still, end of the day, our solar cover all our consumption, so we will have no usage of the battery, and that's a typical day. Going to Sunday, that's how you actually will see it here, where we start charging and the jackedness is because of clouds. And then we hit almost full charge, or the full voltage on the Tesla battery, and then it actually drops down in here. Again, water heater kicks in, and we basically just sustaining the load from the sun in here. So looking at all the energy, as it looked in here, we almost generated no energy during the day when it was raining all day long. But still, we actually managed to just keep the voltage straight at least, so we didn't take energy out of the battery. We basically made the same, and then of course coming the night we started using batteries again. Next day we were not able to fill up, so again we start draining, and then the second day we fill up. So basically we have all the way from Tuesday until Saturday without a full charge actually in here. But we never really hit lower than, if we go look at it here on Friday morning, this one is where we have 100% up here, 80 or 60. It was right below 40% state of charge actually in here. Again, the curve follows really closely for the voltage being the blue one and the state of charge in here. We use an Elgato device to actually track many of the usage we have on a 120 volt system. So this one is some of the devices we have. We have like a battery heater using around 300 watts this time of year to keep the Tesla battery at 65 degrees or higher out there. A computer using more than the battery heater actually. And then we have some monitoring that's constantly have a screen showing the status of the battery using a Raspberry Pi. We have a TV and a media computer, networking gear, and this one is where it gets interesting. Our networking gear consists of a router and a hard drive with a lot of movies on. We use around 1 kilowatt hour a day actually in here. Our refrigerator, a very efficient Fisher and Paykel, use the same amount of energy, 1 kilowatt hour a day actually this time of year. If the inside temperature get higher, this one will increase in the summertime. We also use a HugeNet satellite internet connection, getting around 600 watt hours per day. So combining our networking gear and our satellite, it uses 50% more than our refrigerator actually. But our highest consumption is the electric water heater. Even if we don't take a shower, just to have hot water requires 2 kilowatt hours. If we take showers, it will of course need to heat more water, and it gets up to around 3. This one actually decreases in the summertime because the temperature inside will be warmer than outside, and we will have less losses for that power. Now putting all this data into a diagram or into Excel in here, it will show our total consumption per day. It don't really vary much depending on if it's a bad day, being Thursday out here, or it's being one of the better days. So that our 120 volt consumption is basically the same almost every day. This time of year, around 6.5 kilowatt a day out here. The input from the sun varies quite differently in here. So you can see some days we get around 10 kilowatts. So the difference is the 6.5 minus or subtracted from the 10 kilowatt is 3.5 kilowatt for other things. This one is losses, 12 volt usage and other things like that one. But coming Thursday, we had only 3 kilowatt coming in actually in here. We'll be drawing from the batteries overnight again. Even on a bad day, we don't draw much more from the battery because the sun just supplies enough energy, even when completely overcast and raining all day, to cover the daily loss. But we didn't charge much because we basically consume all of it. And then the next couple of days, we charge a lot more into the battery, and then we end up again in the stable scenario out here. So our lowest state of charge was 38.8% down here. So looking at that in a graph, the orange is the input from the sun. The blue is what we consume on 120 volt. And then what we draw from the battery and what we charge into the battery. So Thursday, we almost charged nothing. And we didn't get a lot of energy from the sun either. But our consumption is basically flat in here, using around these 10 kilowatt hours per day actually in here. All this data is also available on our website. So if you want to go look at our status over time, if you go to our offgrid100.com website, you can look at the daily status. And here you can actually see starting in November or October 2018, you have all the data in here. And this one we updated around every 14 days or so. But you can see in here that all the graph is in here, so you can actually look at it. And if you want to see it in full resolution, you could even download the picture in here. But this one gives you also a lot more statistics if you actually wanted to follow all this.